I want us to pray for one very important prayer topic. That is about marriage. Marriage. We are going to pray for people who are married. And if for some reason you are not married, then you will be praying for any relationship that you are in. It could be your relationship with your children, your relationship with your co-workers, your relationship with your friends, your relationship with your manager or your superiors, or your relationship with somebody you are planning to marry. Today, my number one prayer is on praying about marriages. But if you are not married or you are single, then there are other relationships in your life which is important to you. And so I want you to begin to lift up prayers for this relationship, that the Lord will make them healthy. Healthy relationship whereby the enemy will not blow away your good friends, even in Jesus' name. Because God told me that there's another level of attack coming against marriages. And so today we want to pray for people who are on the phone line who are married, that whatever the devil is planning against anyone's marriage, that today we are going to overthrow them, we are going to root them out, we are going to pull them down, and we are going to destroy them. It could be your relationship with your children. The devil comes in to kill, to steal, and to destroy. He may want to bring separation between you and your child. He may want to bring a separation between you and your good friends. He may want to come and bring a confusion between you and your co-workers or your manager. If you are not married, then you may pray about any relationship which is important to you, that the Lord will protect that relationship and keep it healthy. If you are married, you want to pray that tonight every plans of the enemy that he has fabricated, that he has planned, that he has plotted against your relationship, your marriage, today whatever the devil has sown in your marriage, we are rooting them out. The devil is coming in and he has sent his demons and principalities to begin to sow into people's marriages confusion, anger, strife, lack of love, disrespect for each other, no lack of communication, there is no harmony in the house, and he's separating husbands and wives, and is trying to wreck the marriage with divorce and separation. And people even whose marriages have been servant want to pray for restoration, that the Lord himself will restore. So today my number one concern is that God says that a great and demons have been released against marriages. And so tonight I want us to immerse our marriages under the blood of Jesus Christ, and every seed of conflict, misunderstanding, lack of love, lack of communication, disrespect, anger, strife, contention, we are rooting them out of the marriage, and we are praying, releasing love, unity, understanding, oneness of mind. It could be your relationship with your child, that the Lord God Almighty will touch your children so much that they will listen to you and take your advice, and so that it will be well with them. It could be your relationship with your co-workers. Some of you at your workplace, people are not getting along with you, and it is always a problem, or your manager is always giving you problem. You want to pray that the Lord will grant you favor with any relationship that you are in. We are praying against every enemy of relationship tonight. And so tonight we are coming against these demons, we are coming against this witchcraft spirit, we are coming against these principalities and powers that are working against people's relationship. Whatever they are intending against your marriage, tonight we are rooting it out. When we read Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 9, it says that God has given us the power to root out, to pull down, to destroy, and to throw down. So as we pray, you are going to be rooting out every seed of contention and conflict and chaos and confusion the devil has already started planting in your relationships. And you are pulling down every walls of lack of communication and respect and love, and destroy every plan that the devil has set in place against husbands and wives, parents and children, you and your co-workers, or whoever God, any relationship that is dear to you. Tonight we are going to soak your relationship under the blood, and you are going to take authority in the name of Jesus Christ and destroy every plans of the enemy against your relationship. It could be your marriage, it could be your relationship with your children, it could be your relationship with your ex, it could be a relationship with your co-workers or your manager. Whatever relationship that you are in which is important to you or dear to you. Pray for protection and pray and cast out all these demonic spirits who are trying to bring conflict and chaos and confusion, that the Lord himself will bring deliverance to you and maintain peace, harmony, unity, love, and oneness of mind in your marriage, in with your children, with your co-workers, with your manager at your workplace, so that wherever you are, the favor of the Lord will be in your relationship, even in Jesus' name. So this is one of the most important things we are going to pray in the relationship. Some of you are already single, and the devil has been fighting against your marriage. He doesn't want you to get married. Every relationship that you get into it, the devil tries to break it up before it develops into marriage. Today you want to pray and come against these demons that are fighting against your marriage. Any spirit, every marital spell, every marital curse, today I want you to root it out. I want you to pull it down. I want you to destroy it. I want you to throw it down in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are coming against principalities. We are coming against powers. We are coming against witchcraft. We are coming against demons that have been sent in any relationship that we are in. We are destroying their plans, even in Jesus' name. And we are going to stand on Matthew chapter 5, verse 13. It says that every plant that my heavenly Father has not planted will be pulled out by its roots. Whatever seed, whatever the devil has sown in your relationship, which is not making your relationship fruitful, and it is not making it healthy, and it's not making it lasting, you are going to root it out by the roots. When we talk about root, it means that they are deep-rooted issues and they are demonic spirits. So you have to be violent as we pray, even in Jesus' name. So please join me as we pray right now in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So please say this after me. And after that, you and I begin to pray and immerse your marriage or your relationship with your children or your relationship with anybody who is dear to you under the blood, that God will preserve it, even in Jesus' name. Say this after me. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Ghost, by the power of the Holy Ghost, I repeat again, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Ghost, I take authority and dominion to root out, to pull down, to destroy, and to throw down, to root out, to pull down, to destroy, and to throw down every plans of the enemy against my marriage, against my family, against my relationship. I root them out. I come against every plan of the principalities. I come against every plan of powers. I come against every plan of the rulers of darkness in high places. I come against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. I destroy every demonic activities. I destroy every witchcraft activities against my marriage. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, I root out. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pull down. In the name of Jesus Christ, I destroy. In the name of Jesus Christ, I throw down every plan of the enemy, every plan of demons, every plan of principalities, every plan of powers, every plan of witchcraft against my marriage, against my relationship, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, whatever you have not planted in my relationship and the devil has sold, I root it out in Jesus' name. Let's begin to pray. So your simple prayer is that anything that the devil has sown in your relationship, root it out. It could be confusion. It could be lack of love. It could be lack of communication. It could be something that has risen between you and your husband, you and your children, you and your co-workers, you and your manager. Whatever relationship problem that has arisen, today pray in the name of Jesus Christ and cast it out and win the victory in the spirit, and it will manifest in the physical, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power and the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Tonight, we take authority. Tonight, we take authority in the name of Jesus Christ to root out, to pull down, to destroy, to throw down all the plans of the enemy against our marriages, every seed of confusion, every seed of misunderstanding, every seed of lack of love, every seed of contention, every seed of disrespect, every seed, oh Lord Almighty, of lack of communication, every seed of that is bringing suppression between husbands and wives, between children and their parents, tonight in the name of Jesus. Every demon, every principalities, every powers, every rulers of darkness in this age, every spiritual host of wickedness in heavenly places, every demon, every witchcraft, every agent that is sowing seed in this marriage, in this relationship, tonight, in the name of Jesus, I root their plans out. I pull it by its roots. I destroy their plans. I frustrate their plans. I annul their plans. I scatter their plans. I dismantle their plans. In the name of Jesus, I soak my marriage. I soak my relationship with my children. I soak my relationship to my with my co-workers. I soak my relationship under the blood of Jesus Christ. That no weapon fighting against my marriage, no weapon fighting against my marriage by these demons, by these principalities, by these powers, by these witchcraft, by these powers, the spiritual wickedness in high places, all their plans against my life and my marriage and my family will not prosper. Tonight I destroy their plans against my marriage, their plans against my spouse, their plans against my wife, their plans against my husband, their plans, oh God, I break their influence. I break their manipulation. I break all of their control over our marriage in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, whatever you have not planted in our marriage, we root it out. We root it out. Every confusion, every misunderstanding, every separation and divorce, we cast it out. We cast it out. We bind these demons. We bind these principalities. We bind these powers. We bind these spiritual hosts of wickedness in high places. We bind these witchcraft. We bind these agents, and we cast them out of our marriages in the name of Jesus. Father God, anyone on this phone line, I pray for their marriage. I immerse their marriage under the blood of Jesus. Under the blood of Jesus. May the blood of Jesus protect their marriage. May the blood of Jesus protect their relationship with them and their children. May the blood of Jesus protect, oh God Almighty, their relationship at their workplace. May the blood of Jesus protect them in the name of Jesus. Every weapon, every plus of the enemy against their relationship, I destroy it in Jesus' name. I destroy it in Jesus' name. I root it out. I pull it down. I destroy it. I throw it down in Jesus' name. Tonight, all their trust, we break it. We break their trust. We break their plans. We break their snares. We break their agendas. We break their plans. No weapon that is fighting against our marriages, no weapon that is fighting against our relationship will ever prosper. And every list that is risen against us in judgment, tonight we condemn it in Jesus' name. Tonight we condemn it in Jesus' name. Our relationship will not break. Our relationship will not collapse. Our relationship will not fail in Jesus' name. Father, deliver our relationships. Deliver our marriages. Deliver our marriages. Deliver our children. Deliver our spouse in Jesus' name. Every witchcraft controlling spirit, we break their hold. Every witchcraft manipulating spirit, we break their hold. Every witchcraft influencing spirit over our marriages, over our relationship, we break it. We lose our marriages. We lose our relationships. We lose our children. We lose ourselves from every negative forces in Jesus' name. Father, tonight, we pray that, Father God, you deliver marriages from separation and divorce. Father God Almighty, those who are believing you, O Lord, to restore their marriage, remember, I repeat that, remember, O God of my master, remember your children, remember, Father, we pray for restoration in marriages, in the name of Jesus. I pray for love. I pray for peace. I pray for understanding. I pray for harmony. I release it in Jesus' name back into their marriages in Jesus' name. Father, tonight we bind every strong man. We bind every stronghold. And we cut them out of our families, out of our children's life, out of our spouse. Every spouse, anyone whose spouse is under the influence of witchcraft spirits, and they are manipulating and influencing their attitude and behavior, today, in Jesus' name, we break their mind loose. We break their mind loose. That Father God, they will get clarity. Clarity of mind to be able to do the right thing. In Jesus' name, we lose their mind. We lose anyone whose spouse is under the influence of witchcraft, manipulation, control, and influence. We break them loose by the power of the Holy Ghost. That Father God, they will begin to love on their wives, love on their husbands, and love on their children, and do the right thing. In Jesus' name, tonight we pray for a restoration in marriages, a restoration between parents and their children, a restoration between cousins and people and their cousins and their friends and their co-workers and their boss. We pray for restoration. Release your favor upon us, O Lord, tonight. Every demon that the devil has released against our relationships, today we resist them. We resist them. We bind them. We rebuke them and resist them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. They have no control. They have no authority. They have no dominion over our marriages and our relationship. In Jesus' name, may our marriages, may our relationships prosper. Father, I pray for everyone who is single on this prayer line, that Father, in the name of Jesus, may you release their rightful life partner to them in Jesus' name. Every marital spell that is hindering them from breaking through in the area of marriage, I break that spell. I break that curse. I break them loose. And I release them. And I release their spouse into manifestation into their lives in Jesus' name. Father God, those who have already gone through marriage break, I pray that you call for them. You strengthen them. Those who are looking for restoration, restore. Restore, bring their prodigal husbands back to their senses. Any husband who is cheating on their wife, Father, touch them, loose them. And Father, release them to begin to do the right thing and to love on their family once again. In Jesus' name, we pray for restoration. We plead the blood. We use the blood against the enemy. For we overcame the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Today, the blood is winning victory for us in our marriages. May everyone on this phone line, may their marriages stand in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, expose our enemies. Disarm our enemies. Disgrace our enemies. And destroy their plans concerning our relationships. In Jesus' name. Recover ourselves and our marriages and our relationships with our children, our relationships with our co-workers, our relationship with our friends, our relationship at our workplace. In Jesus' name. May your blessing bring us together with love, which can never be broken. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians, it says that, for God who said, let light shine out of darkness, God called light out of darkness. Tonight, whatever situation you are going through, Corinthians, the book of Corinthians makes us to understand that God called light out of darkness. He called things which were not as though they were. Tonight, I want you to prophesy into your darkness and call forth light. Call forth your healing. Call forth your deliverance. Call forth your breakthrough. You are calling light out of darkness. That is strange. Because the Bible says that in the beginning, God said, let there be light. The world was full of darkness. But God called light out of darkness. And that which was not became. Because there is power in the word of God. And the Bible says life and death lies in the power of the tongue. Tonight there is power in your tongue. And I want you to release the power by faith in Jesus' name. And call forth light into your darkness. It could be a marital situation. Call forth light, that there will be peace, that there will be joy, that there will be understanding, that there will be harmony in your marriage. Call forth light into your health. Maybe you are sick and afflicted with pain, but as you call forth light, healing strength will come into your body. Maybe you are bound. Call forth light, and God will set you loose from every chains of the enemy. Maybe you need to call light out of your darkness, financial strength. Finally, you need help from God. A major breakthrough, and God will bring light, will bring help. Whatever you are looking for, I want you to begin to prophesy. Maybe you need God to touch your children, God to touch your wife, God to give you favor as you go for an interview. Call forth light. Call forth light. Call forth things which are not as though they were. The Bible says that let the weak say, I am strong. Prophesy, son of man, prophesy tonight into your situation and call for the outcome. Whatever outcome you want, call it forth in the name of Jesus Christ, and the Lord will do it for you, even in Jesus' name. Some of you call forth restoration in your marriage. Some of you call forth healing in your body. Some of you call forth your pregnancy, your children into manifestation. This year you will break forth and you have your child. Call forth healing. Call forth understanding in your marriage. Let's call for things which are not as though they were. For God called light out of darkness. Let's pray right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, for your word says that the scriptures cannot be broken. If you, O God, call things which are not as though they were, and they became manifested. Father, tonight, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we prophesy into our darkness. We prophesy into our darkness. That, Father, we call forth light in every area of darkness in our lives, oh God. Father, I pray for those who are sick on this prayer line. I call for the light of healing. The light of healing. The light of healing. May your angels touch them right now. And may they be loosed from the bondage of affliction and pain. In Jesus' name. Anyone who has been bound, oh Lord, by these marine demons and fighting against their marriage, oh Lord. Everyone bound by marital spells, I bring them loose in Jesus' name. I bring them loose from every choke tie. I bring them loose from every demon that oppresses them. I loose them in Jesus' name. I release their joy. I release their marriage. I release their peace. I release liberty. I release liberty. I release liberty. For wherever the Spirit of the Lord God is, there is liberty. I release liberty and joy into their lives. I send light into their darkness. I come against depression. I come against fear. I come against worry. Father, I call forth light into people's marriages. Father, anyone whose marriage is going through problems, whose mind is being shaken by the foundation, today I call for light. I call for light. May the light of the Holy Ghost, may the light of Jesus cast out every demonic spirit. And I send your light of peace. I send your light of love. I send your life, your light, O Lord, of understanding, communication, and restoration in their marriage. I send your light, O God Almighty, of understanding in their family, in Jesus' name. Father, those who need financial breakthrough, I call forth light into their darkness, that you will make a way for them where there seems to be no way. Father God, supply Jehovah all their needs according to your riches and glory. Make a way for them. Those who are looking for jobs, make a way for them to find that job. Those who need a raise, make a way for them, O Lord. Those who need financial favors, make a way for them in Jesus' name. There is nothing too hard for you, Jehovah. There is nothing so hard for you. Father, those who need you to revive them. Father, tonight, in Jesus' name, I send your light, the light of Jesus, in their life, that you revive them, you strengthen them, you help them to know you better and walk with you, O Lord Almighty, that their names will be written in the Lord's book of life. I send light into their family members who do not know you, that, Father, they will come to the saving knowledge of Jesus. I send your light of restoration into people's lives, people's family, people's destinies, in Jesus' name. Father, those who have always been expressing limitation and retrogressing, and they seem not to be able to find their purpose in life, may this year, may this month of March, may shine your light into their lives, that they will begin to march forward. They will begin to realize their destiny. Their star will shine. In Jesus' name, I call things which are not as though they were. I send light into our darkness. I pray for healing. I pray for deliverance. I pray for salvation. I pray, oh God, that you visit your children tonight. In Jesus' matchless name have we prayed. Knowing that, Father God, you begin to perform a miracle tonight. A miracle tonight. A miracle tonight. Every possibility, may it be turned into possibilities in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, for shining your light into our darkness and paving the way. May every crooked path be made straight, and may every mountain be leveled in Jesus' name. May every mountain be leveled Every mountain builders, I bind them and cast them out. And may every mountain that stands before your children, financial mountain, marital mountain, mountain, O Lord Almighty, with your children, mountain, every mountain that stands before them, I roll it away. I pray for deliverance in Jesus' name on this phone line. Help them, O God. Help them, O God. Save them, O God. Deliver them, O Lord. Grant them the grace and restore their marriages. Restore their relationships. In the name of Jesus, heal their bodies, O God. Strengthen them. Make a way for them. See them. Grant them grace. Those who are going through the valleys of the shadow of death. Those who are going to the valleys of shadow of death, those who are going to tribulation, those who are going through hard times in their lives. Father, I send your light into their darkness. That Father God, you who is the God of mercy, will tonight grant them mercy. Who you are the God of comfort, you will comfort them and grant them the grace to come out of their problem, strengthened, toughened, wiser, and with much more twice double blessing. Anyone going through tough times, Father, remember them and assist them. Remember them and sustain them. Remember them and grant them grace. For your grace is sufficient for them in their weakness. So, Father God, anyone who is going through a tough time in their life right now, a tough time, and they feel hopeless, they feel very hopeless, they are almost giving up, tonight, strengthen your children. Tonight, let them know that you are working things for their good. And tonight, let them know that you are with them. And so they shouldn't be afraid. I prophesy into their darkness that they will know that Jehovah God is with them. God, you are with them. You will see them through the fire. You see them through the waters. And you quiet every storm in their lives. And you bring them out. Father God, touch them. Whoever is on this phone line who is at the verge of giving up, Father, touch them. Whoever is on this phone line whose heart is burdened, whose heart is quieted, who is depressed, Father, strengthen them tonight. Let them know that you are the God of comfort. Comfort them today. Comfort Zion today. Strengthen them. Let them know that you are in control. And you are working all things together for their good. Let them know that your presence is even with them as they are going through the valleys of the shadow of death. You are their helper. You are their strength. You are their support. Give them strength, oh God. Give them the grace to go through and come out. In Jesus' name, I shine your light. I shine your light. I shine your light into their darkness. May they see light from tonight and let them know that you are with them. Let your presence overwhelm them. Let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding keep their heart and mind. In Jesus' name, I loose them. Amen and amen.